Hi everyone, welcome to this video about upgrading Debian 9 to Debian 10. There might be various reasons on why you want to upgrade your system, and probably you already have one since you're watching this video. It might be because you want to install newer software, or simply because your current version ran out of support. For example, for Debian 9, official support ended July 2020. This was more or less a year after the release of the new version, Debian 10 or Buster. Before we get started, I'd like to point out that I also have a blog, jensd.be, where you can find all information that I will share in this video and more. So if you're interested in going through this yourself, I really recommend you to have a look there. You can find a link in the description. But let's go back to the upgrade, and the upgrade will take place in three steps. First step is the preparation, which will probably take most of your time. Second step, which is divided in two steps on its own, is the actual upgrade, where we first do a minimal system upgrade followed by a full system upgrade. And step three is the cleanup, which we'll do after the installation is successful. Let's start with the preparation. The upgrade of the system itself is usually pretty painless, but it's the installed software or packages that will cause a headache. For example, when we went from Debian 8 to Debian 9, Apache 2 also got upgraded from 2.2 to 2.4, which required a lot of configuration changes. This got partly automated, but it still required a lot of testing. Another example could be if you upgrade a database server, that you need to run some scripts after the upgrade completed, or you need to do some tuning. Therefore, it's important that before you do the upgrade, you check which versions will be upgraded, and place to be for that is the release notes, where you can find all information which you need for that. Unfortunately, there is no easy method or simple fix. So if you need to upgrade a critical or a production system, it's important to go through this and test this thoroughly. Another thing to do before going through the upgrade is, it should be obvious, take a proper backup. And the chance that the upgrade will touch your actual data is rather small, but it will definitely make changes in configuration files and etc, for example. An easy method to do this is to take a snapshot with your hypervisor or use a tool like Timeshift. Last part of the preparation is to make sure that your current version, Debian 9 in this case, has all the latest packages installed before going to the next release. So let's start now with having a look at where we are before we start the upgrade. As you can see, this system is on Debian 9, and to make sure we have all the latest for this release, we can simply run apt update, followed by apt upgrade, and apt full upgrade. Now our system is ready to start with the upgrade to the new release. First thing which we need to do is change etc apt sources.list. In this file, we need to replace the current releases name stretch for Debian 9 with the new releases name buster for Debian 10. You can also use stable instead of the current stable releases name. But if the next version, which is 11 or Bullseye, will be released, you might run into trouble if you want to postpone the upgrade at that point. Since sources.list is changed, we need to load the new package list by running apt update. Right now, we are starting the actual upgrade. As mentioned in the beginning, this will be done in two steps. First, we perform a so-called minimal system upgrade. The minimal system upgrade only upgrades the packages that can be upgraded without requiring any other packages to be removed or installed. As you can see, a list with changes that require your attention comes up automatically. This is very helpful in addition to the release notes. We can scroll through the list and close it with Q once done. At some point, you might also get one of these endcursors dialogues. For example, this one asking if you are sure you want to upgrade glibc right now, as this will cause your graphical session to get disconnected. Since we are using the CLI, we are fine with this. Another one comes up with a question if it's okay to restart services automatically during the upgrade. As this is a test system, this is not an issue.
In the meanwhile, all packages and their dependencies are getting upgraded and other necessary configuration actions are taking place. When the minimal system upgrade completes, we can perform the full upgrade. At this point, everything should be upgraded and we are ready to perform a reboot. Once the system comes back and the upgrade process is finished, we can check the same commands as we used in the beginning to check the installed versions. As you can see, and as expected, our Debian 9 installation now has been successfully upgraded to Debian 10. One last thing to do is to clean up the system. We can start by cleaning the cached packages, which are typically in var cache apt. Then we can remove unused packages with the following command. That's it. That's all it takes to get an up-to-date system.
Hopefully the information I shared here will help you to upgrade your system. If you liked this video, please put a thumbs up. And if you like this or similar content, don't hesitate to subscribe to my channel. As I mentioned before, I also have a blog, jenzy.be, where you can find all information which I shared here. Thanks again, and I hope to see you back here soon.